across this video because you're struggling to define exactly what you need to show executive presence, you're not the only one. Executive presence is difficult to define but easily used as a necessary ingredient to win promotions. And executive presence refers to a set of behaviours you should always be working towards, especially if you're an aspiring leader. But is there any research behind what you need to show? Not a lot. Unfortunately, the only studies I can uncover are from industry-related articles that are not peer-reviewed. But there is a great study recently undertaken by global think tank Coqul that I want to share with you now. Executive presence needs three core ingredients, so get a pen handy and take notes. Our first ingredient is gravitas. And this is the most important characteristic. Key behaviours you should show to demonstrate gravitas include confidence when under pressure, decisiveness, integrity, emotional intelligence, a strong reputation, and visionary ideas. Our next ingredient is communication. Key behaviours I want you to show in this area will include advanced speaking skills for any situation, the ability to command the room with charisma, and emotional intelligence should always underpin your conversations in all instances. We use a lot of communication tools at Voice Science to help you build your high-performance communication. So please consider how your voice tone quality is, how logical you are when you speak, as well as your rapport-building skills. On this channel, we have so many videos for you that will give you immediate strategies to apply. So I'll link a playlist that you should check at the end of the video. Our third and final ingredient for executive presence is appearance. Good grooming and physical attractiveness is shown to enhance positive bias for executive presence according to the research. The difficulty with appearance though is that you're in subjective quicksand. There is no one size fits all for everyone in terms of how they look. So it's very important to tailor your presentation and approach according to the company you work for, their branding, and the key contacts that you keep. And remember, executive presence at Google may look drastically different from an executive at Goldman Sachs. Over on our website, you can find a blog with many more ideas if you need to add fuel to your executive presence. You can also pick up your communication growth plan for work, which will give you the chance to make a personal development plan for your speaking in the year ahead. Use the Communication Growth Plan workbook to select which activities you want to increase and which barriers you want to crush. I've designed this workbook for you to take a moment to forecast how your skills are tracking across key high-performance communication targets like voice tone, speech flow, soft skills, and so much more. Our team read the research to help you personalize your communication style to exhibit your leadership potential effectively. We'll analyse your workplace hierarchy and reported environment to pinpoint who the key players are and strategise with you a game plan to optimise your position by incorporating targeted communication strategies that indicate your leadership attributes. We'll even help you with your efforts to move up the ranks by strategising your pitch, promotion bids and requests to set you up for a higher chance of success. So make sure you check out our services pronto if you want to up-level your executive presence at work. We work with clients and teams all over the world. Remember, we're only an email away. Thank you so much for tuning into this vlog. If you found it helpful, and indeed if you need strategies to optimize your personal communication at work, don't forget to subscribe to this channel, The Voice Science. My name is Sarah Lobigeiger, Dare Rodriguez, Chief Speech Pathologist at Voice Science. Don't forget to give this one a thumbs up, and I'll see you next time. Ciao.
Enchantée.